Buenos dias, good afternoon, good evening, wherever you are in this beautiful world. Whenever you're watching this video, welcome to the Bitcoin Family YouTube channel for the newcomers. My name is Didita YouTube. It is very windy. I am coming to you guys from Tulum in Mexico after already traveling the world for 5 years, after going all into Bitcoin with my family. That's why we are called the Bitcoin Family. Today I'm filming from Tulum Beach. I got a new hotel. We are staying there for the next 6 weeks, I think. A beautiful resort with a lot of beautiful rooms and a pool and everything you want, like of a beautiful holiday here in Mexico, Tulum. You can even find sunglasses on the beach. I will give that one to one of my daughters, you know, for free, gratis. In today's video, of course, bombing you with really cool news about Bitcoin, blockchain and life, some really cool Bitcoin charts. Yes, the BFAT indicator and the BamBam indicator. And of course, talking to you about the news I read this morning during my delicious cup of coffee here in Tulum, Mexico. Guys, I'm filming with my iPhone again because the other one, my DJI, can't handle the wind. This one, it can't handle the wind. I need to find something that will stop the wind from disturbing the videos. That is why I'm filming with my iPhone today. Or not to be, guys, Bitcoin. Let's first start with the Bitcoin TA part, guys. The part where I bomb you a really cool chart. This one. Bam! The first news in the Bitcoin TA part is about the tokens, the coins you need to check out if it is up to Cointelegraph. Cointelegraph is telling us to take a look at BNB, of course, BTC, .xem, and Miota, however you say it. So take a look at those five currencies this week. This is the list that Cointelegraph is telling us. It is not my list. My list is completely different. Yes, of course, I believe that these people at Cointelegraph know what they are doing, but I believe that you need to take a look at Pay Network, Plasma Finance, and of course the Family Token, guys. These coins, take a look at them as well. So you have eight coins you need to take a look at this week. Yes, the beach is beautiful. A lot of people early awake already. It's like 7 o'clock now. The sun is still coming up and it's really early and it's still a little bit frio, 24 degrees. I think when the sun comes up, it will be way warmer. A lot of people have been asking me the whole weekend, Didi, do we need to sell Bitcoin? Are we going to crash to 40K? Are we going to crash to 30K? I've been telling them all, stop freaking out. I have been creating videos last week, all week, of this 4 hour chart where we were moving in this huge falling wedge, and that is what I thought. And yes, now check this chart again, this one, bam. Do you recognize the chart? I already shared this chart a couple of times last week, and what did we see this weekend? We exactly moved in that wedge, to the top, to the bottom, again to the top, again the bottom, and now again to the top, and now we broke out of this triangle. The question now is, are we going to close this candle above the top line of this falling wedge? If we close this candle above it, then the next candle will probably try to find support on that line again. So we will go up, come back to that line, and then bam, take off. Or we go up and break back into the falling wedge, and then again make a small movement to the point of this triangle, or break down to the bottom. These are all the options you need to be prepared to if you are doing the trading game. The I like to zoom out. That's why I don't freak out. I like to look at the 4-hour chart. That is why this whole weekend I was not stressing about 41k, 40k, because I already drew this bullish falling wedge pattern last week. And then you don't need to freak out because you believe in your own TA, and then you're like, okay, I think this is going to happen. And then you don't need to freak out. You just zoom out and you see this beautiful Bitcoin moving inside that pattern before it will go upwards. Because this bullish wedge pattern, this means mostly that we continue to the upside. Because we came up, then you form this bullish flag pattern of a falling wedge pattern, but this all leads to bam, up. So that's why I was not freaking out, but zooming out, until now I was right. But let's see how this will continue the rest of the week. Bam, we still have the moon over there, guys. That's where Bitcoin is going, to the moon. The Bitcoin is going to the moon and I'm going to enjoy the sun. Let's now jump into the news part, the part where I talk to you about the news I read this morning during my delicious cup of coffee here in Mexico, Tulum. This part, bam. Yes, sorry guys, I know that the image is a little bit shaky. It's because my arm is shaky and I don't have a good selfie stick for this telephone yet. So I need to buy a new selfie stick or buy something for the wind of this DJI. What I want to talk to you about is about Vitalik Buterin. How do you say this? How do you pronounce his name? Yeah. Comment down below how you pronounce his name. Try to do in the comment how you pronounce his name. Ah, that's a cool one. But Vitalik, guys, he wants to work a little bit on this Ethereum thing, and he wants to take away this gas refund option. And what does it mean? Because this is an option that you can use to store your gas funds and use these gas funds on the moments that the transaction fees are too high. So you can buy cheap gas funds and then use them when the transaction fees are higher, so you skip the high fees in transaction your currencies. And now Vitalik wants to stop this. But there is one exchange, I think it's 1inch, they make use of the Qi product in this Ethereum blockchain. They make sure that you always pay less fees. That is also what you can see on the 1inch website. You can calculate the root of your cheapest fees. So for example, exchanging Bitcoin family tokens to Ethereum, which root would be the cheapest way, which decentralized exchange, all that stuff, you can calculate on 1inch. And now Vitalik wants to stop this. People won't be able anymore to use the saved gas that they bought in cheap in those periods that the fees are really high. I don't think this is very positive for Ethereum. So let's see if they will go through with this. If they will go through with this, that is why I have been tweeting a lot the last couple of weeks about the Binance Smart Chain. Because then I think the Binance Smart Chain will start to grow tremendously, because they will then take business off the Ethereum blockchain because of all those fees. Because people just don't want to pay the shitload of fees for the transactions. And then the solutions that will be built on Polkadot or Binance Smart Chain, they will slowly start to replace those projects on Ethereum, I'm afraid. I don't know for sure yet. Let's see if Vitalik will go through with it. I don't believe he will, but if he will do it, I don't think it's the best choice for Ethereum. But who am I? I'm a Bitcoiner. Bam! Some very positive news, guys. Google Finance just added a separate tab, exclusive tab, to crypto. You can see Bitcoin, you can see Litecoin, you can see Ethereum in the exclusive tab on Google Finance. This is, of course, going to drive more adoption, because now more and more people, financial people that want to see finance on Google Finance, they will now also see crypto. And when Google takes this step, and when PayPal takes this step, and all these mass media huge companies will take those steps, people will slowly start to believe and trust. And when they start to trust, they start to buy. This will lead to a huge accumulation, and again will lead to a supply crisis, because there is not enough Bitcoins. It's only 21 million. And they're already bought up by all the huge companies. So this is going to create higher prices, in my opinion. And there are some more bullish news, guys. There's a company called Rakuten. Rakuten? Rakuten. I don't know. It's a Japanese payment app. They are now going to add Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, and Ethereum to their payment app. That will make it possible to use Bitcoin, Bitcoin Cash, and Ethereum, probably in Japan, because it's a Japanese payment app, Rakuten. How do you say it? Rakuten. I don't know how you say it. But that means you can spend Yoast currencies at 7-Eleven, at Family Mart, at McDonald's, and tons of other stores that are directly connected to that payment app. A huge step again. So yes, in Asia, they are integrating all those cryptocurrencies now into payment apps. And with those payment apps, you can pay at those stores. This is going to lead as well to a lot of mass adoption. Very positive. Bam! And then there is more bullish news, because we have the OLB group from New York, which is an online merchant service provider. So they make it possible for people to create online shops. They also are going to add cryptocurrency now. They are going to add Bitcoin, Ethereum, USDC and DAI, that is two stable coins, to their online merchant platform, which means from that moment on, 8,500 e-commerce shops will be able to accept cryptocurrencies as a payment. This is all bullish news, guys. This is why I believe that all that negative FUD news we saw last week just wanted to drop the Bitcoin price so these huge companies can buy in cheaper and cheaper and cheaper. This is all FUD. Don't believe the shit that in Dubai, the funds are going to dump Bitcoin because Bitcoin had its best period. This is creating FUD to dump the prices so that you with your weak hands will sell your Bitcoins and they buy them up cheaply. Don't fall for it. Always zoom out. Don't freak out. Stay cool. Buy and add Bitcoins every day and just hodl a couple of more months and years, and you will be very happy, smiling, and maybe walking with me together here on this beautiful beach in Tulum. Because let's be very honest, all this that you see, the life we have been living at the family, the huge Bitcoin family we are creating on Discord, is all made possible because of one little step we made into cryptocurrency, Bitcoin. And that led to this huge adventure for us as a family, and now will become a huge adventure for millions of people worldwide. So make sure you become part of this Bitcoin family. Go to the links down below this video. Click on the Discord server link. Join our family over there. It's free. We don't charge you anything for that. But you become connected to the Bitcoin family. Then it's like more than 2,800 people talking about Bitcoin, blockchain, and life on a daily basis. We are incentivizing people there with the family tokens by doing trivia games, by doing giveaways, by doing a lot of stuff. And one family token is 50 cents. So yes, come and join us at the Bitcoin family. Maybe you can even buy the Bam Bam indicator or the TikTok indicator, or just use our free BFAT that we are giving away for free, because the referral fees we will be earning because of giving away this one for free, that one will be going into a fund that we will use to help poor people all over the world. That was all the news for the days, guys. That was all the charts for the days. I hope you really enjoyed the video. If you did enjoy this short video, give the video a thumbs up, share it with your friends and family, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and please leave a comment, as I love to respond to your comments. Thanks for watching. Always remember to zoom out in Bitcoin and to zoom in that life. Try to enjoy every single minute of the day, as that is exactly what life should be about. Again, I wish you an amazing day, and hopefully see you tomorrow again with a new video from another location here in the beautiful Tulum. Bam!